The telephone stands as one of the greatest inventions of the modern age. But forget about the rotary or the touch-tone phone. It's all about the iPhone and Android. These are the names that dominate our understanding of telephones today. Not only can we connect people from opposite ends of the world, but nowadays we can snap pictures, send videos, and explore the internet all from one device. Today, you don't hear the word telephone so much as you do the word mobile. But there was a time when the telephone existed as something very different. Let's take a trip back in time to the 1800s when Alexander Graham Bell debuted the very first telephone. A Scottish immigrant who had settled in Ontario, Canada, he had been fascinated with sound technology and sought a way to transmit speech electronically. In 1876, that dream became a reality when Bell received a patent for his revolutionary new invention, the telephone. Of course, this wasn't quite like the sleek, pocket-sized designs of today. To an iPhone user, it probably looks more like a trumpet than a telephone. But back then, this device transformed communication as we knew it. Fast forward to the 1970s, and the world saw telephones starting to shift from analog to digital transmission. And now, forget about telephone cords and dial tones, smartphones have quickly taken the world by storm. Now, in the 1900s, telephone technology looked and operated a whole lot differently. While today you can send instant messages, images, and voice clips over Wi-Fi, this wasn't always the case. For most of the 1900s, the world only knew landlines as the most effective form of communication. Remember, this was a time when, up until recently, mailing a letter or sending a telegraph had been the fastest way to reach someone. Nowadays, mobile phones have made instant communication the norm. But back then, being able to make a call from your own home was revolutionary. When landlines first graced American households around the 1920s, the popular model was the candlestick phone. This was a two-piece phone where you would hold the speaker to your ear and talk into a central base. The common rotary phone followed. This model had the ear and mouthpiece set together with a dial on the base. You would spin and release each digit of the phone number with your finger to make a call. Compared to the touchscreen dialing of mobiles today, making a call back then took a whole lot longer. Luckily, push-button telephones came along in the 1960s. These models used touch-tone dialing, which quickly became the standard worldwide. Another great phone-related invention? Answering machines. Nowadays, instant messages have almost replaced the need for voicemail entirely. If you can't get through to someone, just drop them a quick text. But back in the 1970s, answering machines were a giant leap forward. And it all started with one little phrase, "Please leave a message after the beep." Before that, there was no way to know if you'd missed someone's call. Nowadays, voicemail services are built into our cell phones. Back then, bulky answering machines would sit next to the phone blinking when you had a message. The 80s saw a rise in the popularity of the pager or beeper. If you left the house, you know, where your only phone was bolted to the kitchen wall, someone could page you. Your pager would beep and show you the number to call back on a small display. This was great and all, but now you still needed to find a phone to call the person back. But perhaps the biggest milestone in the evolution of telephone technology was overseas transmission. Expanding telephone service across continents was always a top priority. The first transatlantic cable was laid in 1956 between Canada and Scotland. With the new cable system, transatlantic telephone traffic soared from 1.7 million calls in 1955 to 3.7 million in 1960. Of course, back then, the cost of long-distance calls made them somewhat of a luxury. Nowadays, internet capabilities make distance irrelevant. The expansion of Wi-Fi networks allows us to make calls anywhere in the world at no extra cost, shaping the face of global communications as we know it. The evolution of this technology quickly transformed the way users make a call. Nowadays, we can connect to anyone around the world within seconds. But in the early 1900s, things were a little more complicated. Back then, telephones operated through an additional middleman, a switchboard operator. Nowadays, the image of telephone operators only appear in old-time movies. But back then, they were an essential part of modern life. So, how did it work? Well, in the early days of the telephone, one phone could be connected to another by a wire, allowing the two owners to speak. While that was a marvel at the time, it was clear that the telephone could be more useful if it could connect with numerous other phones. The solution? Telephone exchanges. A user could call a central exchange and give the operator the name of the person they wanted to talk to. The operator would then connect the two phones via a cord on the switchboard, and voila! Communication became a whole lot easier. Of course, by today's standards, this just seems like a hassle. By the 1930s, technology allowed you to dial multiple other phones, and telephone operators started to become a relic of the past. While today you can make a call from the sidewalk of a busy street, the inside of a restaurant, or while at the mall, the telephone booth was once the way to make a call while on the go. Phone booths weren't just reserved for Superman, you know. Before cell phones, payphones could be found everywhere. You would have to pay a dime or a quarter to make a call and hope you didn't get someone's answering machine because that would waste your money. Imagine a time when you couldn't just reach into your pocket and speak to someone within seconds. While the odd payphone can still be found, many might not recognize one if they saw one. Nowadays, our main concern is finding an outlet to charge our phone. And now, portable chargers have even solved that problem. In the 1970s, the very first cordless landlines were introduced, allowing users to move within a certain range while speaking on the phone. You would pull up the metal antenna and be able to move about the house instead of being tethered by the cord on the phone. Nowadays, mobile phones are our constant companions. We can take calls anytime, anyplace. But back then, moving around your house while making a call was seen as a new freedom. Finally, you could have some degree of privacy on the phone. Unfortunately, this still wasn't enough to sustain the use of landlines. Back in the early 2000s, 9 out of 10 US households had a traditional landline phone. Nowadays, it's just every second household, and the number continues to decrease. In fact, generations today may never lay eyes on a phone hanging on the kitchen wall. Even for businesses, landlines no longer offer the best way to get in touch. The mobility of life today means that cell phones are now the best option. When it comes to comparing mobile phones today, there's one thing that really matters: data. Nowadays, users are looking to make calls, send images, and browse the internet on the go. Smartphones offer the best access for all those functions. But there was a time when cell phones had a much simpler function. The first commercially available cell phone was released by Motorola in 1983. Back then, these cell phones were the size of a brick. Over the past 40 years, the physical design of the cell phone has seen a roller coaster of changes. Remember the classic flip phone from the 2000s? These phones seem to be a nod to the original Star Trek communicator. Nowadays, smartphones have made things even easier with a touchscreen keyboard. You can even dictate your text messages. But back then, you'd see teens all over the world typing out text messages on a phone keypad. Even though you would have to press a key 3 times to get a certain letter, this was a revelation for young people looking to instantly connect with one another in an age without WhatsApp, Facebook, and FaceTime. Now, cell phones have taken on a whole different function. With the advent of the Apple and Android stores, mobile apps have transformed cell phones into pocket computers. The result? Mobile phones have now permeated every part of our daily lives. Need to catch a cab? Back then, your best bet would be to hail one off the street. Now, Uber can connect you to numerous rides with the touch of your screen. It wasn't long before games, music, books, and movies were added, and cell phones became all-in-one entertainment devices that could also make phone calls. Although, who makes calls nowadays? Since the turn of the century, phone providers have been converting their users to wireless mobiles. Users are looking for providers that can offer them unlimited data, text messages, and international call plans. But this wasn't always the case. The Bell Telephone Company was the first provider, formed in 1877. That company later merged into AT&T, a leader of development in the communication age. Back in those days, the industry was dominated by a few major players. But in the 1990s, a bunch of new players entered the scene. The communications network was going cellular. Traditional telephone cables were no longer the only means of mass communication. Now there are numerous networks to choose from, each offering the latest deals and data packages. But while the providers may differ, the choice of phones remains limited. Samsung and Apple continue to dominate the smartphone scene with their Android and iPhone models. With regular updates to the size, design, and function of these smartphones, there is a constant debate over which brand is best, kind of like Coke and Pepsi. So, where does the telephone go from here? What possibilities lie ahead? Does the world of sci-fi hold some clues? Technology has taken their cues from TV and movies in the past. In the last two decades alone, the changes made to phones have been huge. Assistants like Siri have given cell phones more accessibility and, in many ways, more personality. As smartphone technology becomes more intuitive, we're growing increasingly attached, always connected. Smartphones will probably continue to exceed our consumer needs in so many ways, bringing them closer into the fabric of our daily existence, if that's even possible. Thanks for checking us out. Leave us a comment, hit that subscribe button, and ring that notification bell. Oh, and for more great videos, just tap or click.